JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 3rd. I am Charalambos, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, as always, let's start with the performance of the dollar. The dollar traded higher against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It gained the most versus the euro, SEK and the Swiss franc, in that order, while it lost some ground versus the Canadian dollar. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Norwegian krone. The fact that the greenback continued to strengthen suggests that market participants remained concerned with regards to the economic damages caused by the fast spreading of the coronavirus. Indeed, after the initial jobless claims more than doubled their prior record of 3.3 million, shockingly hitting 6.65 million and topping the upper end of the economists' forecasts, which was at 5.25 million, global equity indices traded in negative waters. However, major EU and US indices finished their sessions in green territory, gaining after US President Trump said he expects Saudi Arabia and Russia to agree to an oil production cut of up to 10 to 15 million barrels per day, as the two nations appeared willing to find common ground. On top of that, Saudi Arabia said it would call for an emergency OPEC gathering, as the prior output cut deal expired on March the 31st. Oil prices jumped on the reports, with both Brent and WTI surging 21.02 and 24.67% respectively, their biggest daily gains percentage-wise on record. Maybe that's why both the Canadian dollar and NOK were among the top G10 performers. Let's not forget that both the Canadian and Norwegian economies depend heavily on oil exports. Here you can see the graph of USD CAD and WTI. WTI is inverted here, and you can see that there is a strong negative correlation between USD CAD and WTI. Currently, that correlation since the beginning of the year stands at -0.97. Now let's continue. As I said, maybe that's why the Canadian dollar and the Norwegian krone were among the top G10 performers. Let's not forget that both the Canadian and Norwegian economies depend heavily on oil exports. So why did the dollar continue to gain even after the rebound in oil prices and equity indices? Perhaps because the US is the top oil producing nation in the world. Now, having said all that, oil prices retreated during the Asian session today, dragging equity indices along them. Although Japan's Nikkei 225 closed virtually unchanged, China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng are down 0.86 and 0.82% respectively. Perhaps investors had second thoughts about the oil-related reports, with Saudi Arabia and Russia starting a price war after failing to agree on a 1.5 million barrels per day cut. How is it possible to agree on 10 or 15 million? Even if they agree to cut by a smaller amount, will this be enough to offset the plunge in demand due to the coronavirus pandemic? All these questions make us sit to the sidelines despite yesterday's rally. Even if oil prices rebound again, we are reluctant to trust a long-lasting recovery. In order to do so, we would like to see handshakes and signatures, not just headlines and rumors. Now, as for today, the spotlight may turn to the official US employment data and the ISM non-manufacturing PMI, both for the month of March. Non-farm payrolls are expected to have fallen 100K after rising 273K in February, while the unemployment rate is expected to have risen to 3.8% from 3.5%. Bearing in mind that the ADP report revealed that the private sector lost only 27,000 jobs, we wouldn't be surprised if the NFPs declined by less than expected as well. That said, the ADP report appears to be far from a reliable predictor of the NFPs, as the correlation between the two time series at the time of the release, no revisions are taken into account, has fallen notably in recent years. Average hourly earnings are anticipated to have slowed to 0.2% month over month from 0.3%, which, barring any deviations to the prior monthly prints, would keep the year-over-year rate unchanged at 3%. Having said all that, at this point we have to note that both the ADP and the official employment data are based on the total number of employees being active on a payroll through the 12th of the month, and thus they don't reflect the latest impact of the virus on the job market. Investors may prefer to wait for the April data, which may incorporate the astonishing jumps in jobless claims in the last 2 weeks of March. Now, as for the ISM index, it is expected to have fallen to 44 from 57.3. Combined with the decline to 49.1 in the ISM manufacturing PMI, this would drive the three-month rolling average of our ISM weighted composite index sharply lower, which could mean a steep slowdown or even a contraction for the US economy during the first half of during the first quarter of this year. Here you can see the 3 month rolling average of an ISM composite we constructed, and the blue lines are the GDP. Expectations are for a sharp decline in the ISM composite, which could mean a steep slowdown in the US economy. Something like that could increase concerns with regards to the effects of the coronavirus outbreak to the US economy and may trigger another wave of risk aversion. Equities are likely to slide again, and paradoxically, the dollar may strengthen. History has shown that in a dollar-denominated world, the greenback wears its safe haven suit during periods of high uncertainty and market turbulence, even if a potential global economic fallout means deeper wounds for the US economy. Looking forward, we maintain our view that the worst is not behind us yet. With both new infected cases and deaths reaching new records yesterday, you can see that on this graph I am posting almost every day, the lockdowns around the globe may drag longer than previously anticipated, which could hurt even more the global economy. Thus, we stick to our guns that there is room for equities to trade south again as investors seek shelter in safe havens. Now, as for the rest of today's events, we have the final market services and composite PMIs for March from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, and as it is the case most of the times, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. Eurozone's retail sales for February are also coming out, and the forecast suggests a slowdown to 0.1% month over month from 0.6%. This may keep the year-over-year rate unchanged at 1.7%. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock a.m. GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So, goodbye from me, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.